victory is supported by Skyline Drive Corvette Club and Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.
Good evening and welcome to another exciting program on Victory here on BCTV, your channel to your community. Hi, I'm Tom Frank, your Victory host tonight. Tonight we're very excited again to have in one of our great sponsors of the Victory program all year. They've sponsored us and they have been for over 12 years. We have the Masonic Order, Chandler Lodge 227. There's 9 lodges in Berks County and they're all wonderful in their own unique way. Chandler is very strong in numbers and very strong in the community activities that you're going to find out and learn about tonight. So if you're thinking about becoming a member or thought about what the organization was all about, you tuned in to the right program. Stay tuned in and grab a pad and pen because we've got some great information to share with you throughout the program. But before we do that, let's meet our honorary guest that we have with us tonight, Brother Carey.
Good evening. My name is Brother Carey Bortz. I'm currently Worshipful Master of Chandler Lodge number 227 for the ensuing Masonic year of 2009.
Welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Brother Bob.
Good evening. My name is Bob Saferi. I'm a past master and currently the treasurer of Chandler Lodge number 227.
As I said earlier, there's 9 lodges in Berks County, and that's very large for our community. We're very fortunate to have so many active lodges within the community. Chandler has been a great supporter of BCTV, in particular Victory, for all the underwriting that they have done. Tonight we will be honored with another check presentation that Brother Carey, the sitting Worshipful Master, will do with us tonight. But before we get started with that, we want to cover the topics of what we have to go over with. This is a live broadcast for you. If you have any internal questions you want to cover with a comment, you want to phone into the studio, we encourage you to do so. That number was 610-378-0426. And I'll be giving you one other phone number as we go out through the program of the Masonic Lodge Center of how you can contact the lodge. If you have any information about the Masonic Lodge, please contact that number. We'll have that information for you. As we go to our first statement, as far as the mission statement, we have our first graphics to show you. And the graphics is the symbolic symbol, which is noted throughout the world, of Masonic Order. And you'll see that square encompassed with the G. Let's move to Brother Carey, if we could, about the mission statement within the community of Masonic Order.
Okay, to explain those tools that you see before you, the letter G stands for geometry or God. The compasses and the square were tools used by operative masons that actually laid stone back in the early ages. And the Masonic reason for the compass, it basically keeps us within our trained thoughts as to live every day by those that we are taught. And the square is a resemblance of, if the viewers could remember, the old comment of live by the golden rule, or
acting upon the square?
Yeah, acting upon the square, or doing as we be done by. Exactly. Do unto others as you had they do unto you.
We've heard that many a times.
Correct.
In a positive way.
And that's actually a symbolic symbol. So
excellent.
It's not really a bad thing.
Not at all. And I think it's a very good thing to have within our own community. And to have so many active lodges is even more of a great blessing. Before we went on air tonight, we were discussing all the great organizations and agencies that just this lodge and many others do support. One, of course, is BCTV. We also mentioned the Red Cross, the Visiting Nurses, the Veterans. Tell us about more of that, if you could, Brother Bob, as far as all the organizations that symbolically surround the Blue Lodge and how it expands into the other shrines, York Rite and, of course, Scottish Rite.
Okay. Chandler Lodge itself is the Masonic fraternity. One of the attributes that we encourage in people is charity, is to develop a notion of charity within yourself. And Chandler Lodge as a group donates about $10,000 a year in charity money, some of it directly to various groups in the community, Visiting Nurses Program, the BCTV, some of the other ones that you
Red
had
Cross.
Mentioned.
Right.
The Red Cross.
Veterans Association.
But beyond that, within, we also contribute money to other organizations within the Masonic fraternity, who then give money directly to the their community where they are. For instance, we support the youth groups, the Demolay and Rainbow Girls for boys and girls. And then, of course, people are familiar with the Shriners Children's Hospital in Philadelphia. So if you take all of the Masons across the country, we contribute about $2 million a day to charities throughout the various lodges and communities throughout the country.
That's fabulous. Wonderful really news is. To know that support is in our community. As I said, Masonic Order is worldwide. It is in every country. There's lodges in every country and been there for quite some time. Chandler Lodge is over 150 years old within Berks County. We're going to show you a brief video segment explaining more in detail about Masonic Order of Freemasonry. So sit back and enjoy this brief video clip as we move to it at this time.
Organization has had as its members so many men who have positively shaped the destiny of mankind as has Freemasonry. Many of the most renowned men of all time have been Freemasons. They were patriots like Paul Revere. They were 13 of the signers of the Declaration of Independence. They were more than one-third of all the presidents of the United States. They were great men, like George Washington, who served as master of his Masonic Lodge at the same time he was president of the United States. They were unique men, like Benjamin Franklin, statesman, author, and inventor, who twice served as Grand Master of Masons in Pennsylvania. They were loyal men, who supported their respective governments in a divided country during the Civil War. But as Freemasons, they remained a brotherhood undivided. Freemasons were world leaders, like Franklin D. Roosevelt. They were men like President Harry S. Truman, who served as Grand Master of Masons in the state of Missouri. They were great soldiers, like General Douglas MacArthur, who wrote this about Freemasonry: "To do good to others, to forgive enemies, to restrain passions, to love neighbors, to honor parents, to return good for evil, not to cause anger, not to bear false witness, not to lie nor to steal. These are the essential qualities of the moral law of Freemasonry." Freemasons have been courageous men, like the great American astronauts and world heroes such as Buzz Aldrin, who, as commander of the lunar module on Apollo 11, first landed man on the moon.
Four forward, drift into the right level. 30 seconds. 40 feet down, 2.5. Picking up some dust. Great shadow. Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
We've had shutdown.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
At least six other American astronauts have been Freemasons. Throughout history, when good or great things have been accomplished, good men have been involved. And almost always, Freemasons have been there. Freemasons come from virtually every occupation and profession. They are world leaders, and they are your next door neighbors. They are presidents of the United States, and they are workers in small town shops. They are world heroes, and they are your fellow workers. They are doctors and attorneys, teachers, ministers, and rabbis. They are policemen and firemen. They are corporate executives and manual laborers. Freemasonry represents one of the most remarkable sociological phenomena in human history. For so unique is their respect for each other that regardless of their positions or stations in society, within the Masonic fraternity, all of them are equal. Freemasons come from every religion, which is based on the belief in one God. Religious ideologies are never discussed within a Masonic lodge. Yet Freemasonry is the very best friend of organized religion. For all Freemasons are urged to worship God as their consciences require, and they are encouraged to attend their church, synagogue, or place of worship with their family. Political ideologies are never discussed within a Masonic lodge, but all Freemasons are urged to support the government under which they live. Freemasons are among the most patriotic citizens in our society. One of the most fascinating aspects of Freemasonry has always been how so many men from so many different walks of life, with such diverse political, religious, cultural, and social ideologies, can meet together in peace. Never have a political or religious debate. Begin and end their meetings with a prayer. Sing each other's national anthems. Work together in harmony for the benefit of others. And respectfully call each other brother. In all the world, no other organization has ever attained this remarkable achievement. Other than religion and the history of nations, Freemasonry is the most written about subject in the world. Freemasonry is the world's oldest and largest fraternity, with more than 4 million Masons worldwide. There are over 2 million Masons in North America alone. Freemasons are men who do charitable things in their communities. They believe in family values and are taught to place their families and their vocations above the fraternity. They are urged to practice the principles of Freemasonry by being honest and helping others. A Freemason's value to the fraternity is not measured by the number of meetings he attends, but rather by the way he lives his daily life. The Freemasons of North America contribute well over $1.5 million a day, 365 days a year, to charities which they alone have established. Masonic Children's Learning Centers are now being established across North America to help children with special needs. The Shriners Hospitals and Burn Institutes for Children have been built, staffed, and are maintained without any government money. And no patient has ever had to pay for any treatment at a Shriners Hospital. That's because the Shrine Masons and their friends pay for it all. The Masonic Foundation for the Prevention of Drug and Alcohol Abuse Among Children is another example of Freemasonry's concern for and help to mankind. The foundation sponsors the training of school administrators, teachers, and counselors in the Pennsylvania Department of Education's Student Assistance Program. The Drug Abuse Resistance Education, or DARE program, trains police officers to conduct educational sessions for elementary students in their hometowns. The Masonic Conference Center at Elizabethtown is now the official DARE headquarters for the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. The Freemasons of Pennsylvania have made possible the Pennsylvania Youth Foundation to serve the Masonic-related youth groups in Pennsylvania. The foundation is located at the Masonic Conference Center in Elizabethtown, adjacent to the Masonic homes. Throughout the year, the highest quality educational, recreational, and leadership programs are provided for young people from all areas of the Commonwealth. Collectively, these extensive programs represent Freemasonry's unparalleled humanitarian commitment and concern for children. In all the world, there is no better example of Freemasonry's good works than at the Masonic homes in Elizabethtown, Pennsylvania. It is truly the crown jewel of Masonic charity. It is unmatched, not only in North America, but throughout the world. For this, all Pennsylvania Freemasons are most proud. The Pennsylvania Freemasons, their wives, widows, mothers, sisters, and daughters have the comfort of knowing that should the need ever arise, they have a most comfortable home among friends with the finest professional care available. The benefits of membership in Freemasonry extend further than the unique bonds of friendship and fellowship which have always been inherent in the Masonic fraternity. The opportunity to be part of something so significant in society without demanding much of one's valuable time is one of the most appealing aspects of the fraternity for all Masons. A group term life insurance plan is now available at remarkably low rates to benefit the Mason's family. A blood bank and organ donor program is now in place. Through the fraternity, there is now an opportunity to be a part of the Big Brother and Big Sister programs. High-quality educational and self-improvement programs are now available to Masons and their families at substantial discounts. Cultural programs have been introduced throughout Pennsylvania for the benefit of Freemasons.
Hi, if you just tuned in, you're watching Victory on BCTV. Tonight's topic, of course, is Freemasonry. We have with us tonight Chandler Lodge 227 with us in the studio. We have the sitting worshipful master who has a check presentation to offer to BCTV at this time. Let us move to our sitting worshipful master of Lodge 227, Chandler.
Brother Frank, I would like to take this opportunity to present you with our check for our 12th year in a row.
Yes.
To this great organization of the BCTV, and hope to continue the tradition for the next sitting masters.
Absolutely.
Greatly appreciate it.
Thank you again for your support as it's been over the years. I accept this with great honor on behalf of BCTV to help the underwriting of Victory Program along with the other nonprofit organization group, the Skyline Drive Corvette Club, who sponsors Victory as well. With these two organizations helping one program here on BCTV, keeping the program alive for you, the home viewer, to enjoy and to become knowledge within our community. Thank you again to Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Order of Accepted Order of Masons for helping us within this community. You just saw a video segment coming out a few minutes ago of what Freemasonry is all about. We're going to talk about 162 years this lodge has been active here within our community, and they're having their annual banquet in May. But more importantly, let's talk about membership. How can a man of his free will become involved with Masonry?
Well, the first thing to do is, if you do know a Mason, such as your father, your uncle, your brother, and you would be interested in becoming a Mason, just ask him. There's a little motto that we have that you might see on billboards or you might see on bumper stickers. It'll simply say, to be one, ask one. And that way he can get you the petition, you can complete it, and then give it back to that brother. He will then become your sponsor. Another way is you can contact the local Masonic Foundation in your area. Here in Berks County, it's located in West Reading, across from the doctor office building at the Reading Hospital. And if any brethren out there would like to become a brother, all you have to do is call that number, which is 610-372-3660 during the day from, I believe it's 9 to 3 p.m. and just tell them you're interested in becoming a member of Chandler Lodge number 227. There are 8 other lodges represented as well. And also, if any young lady who would like to join the Rainbow Girls, that is also a good opportunity for young kids to get involved with learning to do things the right way, and also being involved with your community in great organizations and great fundraisers. And those age groups are from 12 to 18. And to be a Mason, you have to be at least 18 years old. But the boys' part of the Masonry is the Demolé. And again, they do the same thing as the Rainbow Girls, but you have to be 12 years old to 18 to join that organization as well.
Excellent. And part of the up to $2 million a day throughout this great world of ours that is donated in good causes, it's to help to donate to support Demolé and the Rainbow Girls as well. This lodge, 227 Chandler, is very active in that, along with other 10 non-for-profit organizations that they do assist with and help out.
Sure.
We have a second graphics we'd like to show you, which is called the Friend-to-Friend Brochure. I'd like to just review this briefly with you, because if you see this brochure, which you now see on your screen, Friend-to-Friend, it pointed out in the video, if you saw the video with us tonight, some of the past members of Masonic Orders. For example, George Washington, our first sitting president, one of our forefathers, was actually a worshipful master. This brochure is readily available throughout the community. It is also available at the Masonic Center for you to pick up at any time, which explains to you the connection to become involved with Freemasonry. Brother Bob, I wanted to just touch upon, if we could, the very important year of 1848 for Chandler. Could you give us a brief history of how it really all started with one or a few individuals?
Normally what happens is a group of men, Masons, will petition the Grand Lodge to start a lodge in their community. And in 1848, a petition was submitted to Grand Lodge in Philadelphia for some brethren from Lodge 62, the first local lodge in this area, to start another lodge in Reading. And they did, and of course back then we didn't have a lodge hall as such. They moved around, they met in different restaurants in Reading itself. I think there was it was called the First House on 5th and Penn. That goes way back into the 1800s, and eventually they all grouped together and constructed a building on 5th Street, South 5th, I believe. And then later on, we moved into West Reading, the building in West Reading. Now, there are separate lodge buildings in Birdsboro, in Hamburg, mm-hmm. in Kutztown, and also in Wummelsdorf, Williamson Lodge. So we have quite a few lodge buildings in our area.
We might also mention the Women's Auxiliary Group. Could you touch upon what that's connected to Masonry?
The Eastern Star is another group within Freemasonry for women. So it sort of complements the men Masons. Eastern Star is the ladies group. And then the various other bodies also have ladies auxiliaries. For instance, in the York Rite, some ladies groups who meet sort of informally, but they are a wonderful support to us. Through fundraisers, they raise funds for us to donate to to other various charities.
Excellent. And as you heard through the video, as well as this program, it's a very active lodge in helping to do nothing but the goodness within our community. Brother Carey brought with a short list of very important names connected to this wonderful organization over the years. You just mentioned a few of them through the video segment, but just find out and listen to some of these names associated over the years with Freemasonry.
Okay, under the Masonic presidents of the United States, there was actually a total of 15 of them, starting with George Washington, James Monroe, Andrew Jackson, James Polk, James Buchanan, Andrew Johnson, James Garfield, William McKinley, Theodore Roosevelt, Henry Taft, Warren Harding, Franklin Roosevelt, Harry Truman, Gerald Ford, and Lyndon Johnson. Eight of the 56 signers of the Declaration of Independence were Masons. Those two famous ones are Benjamin Franklin and John Hancock. Foreign leaders, there's 57 of them. And the top names there that people will recognize is King Charles the 13th, Winston Churchill, Edward the 8th, Edward the 7th, Francis the 1st, Francis the 2nd, and Marquis de Lafayette. In the United States Supreme Court justices, there's 52 of them.
Wow.
And on the United States military leaders, there's 32. And some of the popular astronauts that were mentioned earlier in the program, Buzz Aldrin, Gordon Cooper, Virgil Grissom, Jim Irwin, and Wally Schirra.
Wow. So you can hear and see right. how many have been associated in history, associated with Freemasonry. With the time remaining, I want to take this opportunity to thank Chandler Lodge 227 for their great support financially in helping BCTV help underwrite the Victory program. Thank Brother Kerry as well as Brother Bob for coming in tonight to the studio to answer some questions about Freemasonry in general and bring it to you, the home viewer. I'm Tom Frank, wishing you all a great Victory Day.
Supported by Skyline Drive Corvette Club and Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.